share with you some of the items that I brought from my trip in Belarus. And I usually go there to buy used to secure the tubes and bottles during the transport. So this item, for example, this is a mask, pure green tea, and facial steaming mask. I don't know about steaming, I think that's really not the right word to use. But this is what they used. Now remember that these items are all written in Russian. So the translation is however they wanted to translate or knew how. Gosh, tape peeling is going to be quite a bit of a challenge, so instead, I'm going to just show you the products. What do you think of that? But that's the first item. The second item is this. Also sealed. There isn't it. Something I could possibly remove. There we go. I think we're having progress here. There we go. This is pretty. Sure of its quality. Okay, there we go. Nice. sensitive skin, and it claims to have 95% natural ingredients. You should use this during the day. It's supposed to calm the skin, reduce redness, minimize and correct wrinkles. Okay, so this is 35 milliliters. Well, that's one item that we were able to open. What's that? This is a brightening cream. See if we can open it. I see the ending here. There we go. Oh no, it's ripped. Let's see if we can pick it up from here. Oh, so this. Writing here is not very good, so it has. I tried to take some of the tape off and took up some of the writing off as well. Okay, let's see if we can access it from a different point. Alright. Okay, there we go. There we go. Or maybe not. Oh, this is too complicated, right? I'm gonna still try. Resistance is the key, they say, right? Again, this is for my use, so I don't have to make it perfect. So, this is aloe brightening cream. And it said here, it says radiance, energy, antioxidant, lightening. Aloe cream for face. And they claim in that in 100 milliliters of this cream, there are 97 milliliters of aloe juice. Okay, well, that's good. This cream. I think I've actually opened it before. Yeah. So it's kind of like a cream corrector, but it's rather light and really doesn't offer much coverage. But if you have perfect skin, that's the cream for you. What I do with it actually, I mix it with my regular Bare Pro foundation to add a little bit of moisture to it, because Bare Pro is a bit too drying for my skin. Okay, let's see what this says. Attempt this as well. I guess the first thing is to find an end. What is it? Oh yes, I think I did it. Oh, that's a big one. than the thin one, that's for sure. There we go. Try not to make too much noise, but I'm not sure if I'm succeeding. But for those people who like the sticky and crinkly sounds, this might work. So what this item is, it is one of those roll-on deodorants. I hate that it leaves like these sticky residue, but okay, I think we're done here. So that deodorant, kind of an interesting setup. I like the sound. Let sound opening and closing. It's not one of those aluminum-free. This is just a regular one, but it smells really nice. I'll put it back to dry his eyes, but there's some already. So that's that. It has a very mild smell. 50 milliliters, and it claims to protect you for 96 hours. 96 hours. Alcohol free. Okay. Then I've seen that. I think I tried this one and I really like it. This is their new line of cosmetics. And this is a magical cream. That's the translation here. And it has moisture. I mean, it's very moisturizing. But it also has this sort of brightening effect. You know how you add some bronzer onto your cheeks, a highlighter. Well, that sort of does that for you. Look, my nails match almost exactly. is non shine just a little bit, just a tiny bit. Can you see it's not awful, awfully visible, but there's a little bit of this effect that a lot of people go for nowadays. And what I like about it is when mixed with foundation, again, it really offers smooth coverage. So this is a crinkly corrector for redness. So let's see what's inside here. I think it's green, yeah. Okay. So it basically balances out the redness as applies relatively easy. It has definitely some moisturizing. It's not one of those correctors where they're really drying or they have to smooth them out, like look, but also at the same time, not sure how well it will correct redness. I think it's a little bit more of a cream type of thing, so I'll have to try it out to really decide. Let's see if there's another area that I can help. Oh, there we go. You guys all know how much I like cosmetics. But cosmetics that's well made, not the cheap stuff. And although this is cheap, it's actually very well made. And it's cheap is because it comes from a manufacture a company in a country where cost of living is much lower. So in order for people to be able to afford cosmetics of such, prices have to be relatively low. Unfortunately, I think this cosmetic's still being tested on animals. That's always a disappointment for me. Okay, I don't know how to open this. I can't seem to find any scotch tape ends here. Maybe? No. No, is there hope here? Or maybe just needs to be cut. Wait a second, wait a second. What is that? No. Yeah, I can't say I'm thrilled about this job that he did. So this is a gel. I'm just sampling a little bit. It's gel for makeup remove. Makeup removing gel, hydrophilic, from Korean green tea and Japanese matcha tea. And that's the gel. Non-sticky, I would say. Antioxidant protection. It has some hyaluronic acid. And you're supposed to apply it on dry skin. Massage to dissolve any kind of makeup, and then wash it off with warm water. So it's basically like a face gel that it's not, I wouldn't characterize it as a makeup remover. Well, it is, but it's more of a wash off gel, so you have to wash it off. Okay, well, I'll deal with the rest later. Alright, how about this one? Okay, this seems complex as well. Opening it, oh, wait a second, maybe not. Maybe not. Now, how do you fix this part? Oh, there we go. And then let's bind the end of the scotch tape here. It's really hard to find it on this one somehow. Really? Fine. this tape. Oh, there we go. Hopefully it's there. So this is serum for face to moisturize, basically. Okay. Alright, it does feel like serum. It has green tea and cactus. Let's see how it feels. Okay, it's rather liquidy. Really absorbs well, and I'm not sure the moisturizing effect. I'm pretty sure it's you need to add maybe some kind of moisturizer on top of it, but I think that's how it is with serums. It says that, yeah, that's what it says. You can use it either alone or under a day or night cream. Apply a small, look, there's English. Apply a small amount of the serum to your cleansed face with massaging strokes and leave on until completely absorbed. The serum can be used daily as required. A standalone product or as a base for day or night cream. The serum has a cumulative effect when used regularly. I don't know what that means, but okay. Let's find another item. Maybe this one. This is also gel for washing face, yeah, but we'll see if we can find any kind of, I think it's just the lateral one. Okay, let's find an end or beginning to this mess. This is, I've used this cream before, and that's why I purchased it again. It's a day cream that is, I apply this under makeup, and it's not, it's moisturizing, but definitely not greasy. And this is supposed to be for young skin, but I still like it anyway. It doesn't offer a huge amount of moisture, so you can use it as a night cream, or but as a day cream under a foundation is quite good. I think it's also sealed, so I'm not going to open it up. And there's another one like this. I think it's actually used before. These are correctors or foundation type of cream. I really like them. They're for skin with some acne and have quite a difficult skin to manage. So, and it had this one is a dark color, and I use this together with eyes to open up, so let me know if you liked it. And just remember that kindness is the basis of humanity.